This is something what I always wanted to try. I created a very simple board with some tracks routed on the top layer and with solid ground plane on the bottom layer. And I always wanted to see if the return currents for the higher frequencies, if these return currents flow under these tracks. You know, in elementary school, we were always taught that the currents, they flow with the shortest path. But for higher frequencies, the return currents, they flow below the tracks. And that's what I always wanted to see in these simulations. This picture, what is here, this simulation is for 400 Hz, for quite low frequency. And we still can see that the return currents, they somehow try to follow these signals on the board. The blue areas, these are with no current. The red areas are the areas with the highest currents. Okay, so we can see the currents, they somehow try to follow these tracks. But watch what is going to happen when I'm going to increase this frequency. Nicer. Nicer. Wow. You can very nicely see that the return currents, they just follow the tracks. But that's not everything what I always wanted to try. I also wanted to try the simulation. What will happen when I make a big cut in this ground plane? When instead of simulating the board like this, if we simulate something like this, okay? In this ground plane, there is a big cut. So what do you think, what is going to happen with the return currents? How they are going to flow? How the results of the simulation are going to look? And that's what is this video about. We are going to have a look at the return currents for this board, and we are going to have a look at return currents for this board. My name is Robert Feranek, I'm from FEDEVEL Academy, and this is how the schematic looks. Schematic is very simple. There are just three input connectors, three output connectors, but these are basically here just to route these signals on our board, because we would like to see if this return current will flow below this signal. And when we have a look at the PCB, here we can see the three input connectors, three output connectors, and you can see the one of the pins of the connector is always routed on the top layer, and the other pin is connected to the solid ground plane. So the board is very, very simple. Once I decided to create this video, I had to prepare the project. So I created the schematic. Then I placed all the connectors. I was not exactly sure how to route the signals. And initially I placed the signals, or I placed the tracks quite close to each other. And once I had the board, then I created ODB plus plus files. I imported these ODB plus plus files, and then I set up the simulation. I set up the input connectors as the power supplies. The output connectors are sinks, and as you can see, the initial board, it didn't show up very nicely that the signals are, or the return currents are flowing exactly under the tracks because they were routed too close to each other. So basically then I decided to change the board a little bit. I moved the connectors, I moved the tracks a little bit further. Again, I generated ODB++ files. Then imported these files. And I was really curious to see how the first simulation will look. This was much better. And then I was thinking, what next? I ran also DC simulation because I wanted to see and compare the results. And then I created this big cut in the plane. And then I ran the simulation. I'm not going to show you the results yet. because there is also something interesting in the first simulation what I would like to show you. So let's have a look. You maybe noticed at the beginning of this video I stopped at 1 megahertz frequency. And it's because when we go above the 1 megahertz, the results are going to change a little bit. Watch. Okay, so this is 1 megahertz, and I go a little bit higher. And the currents, they suddenly kind of expand. And something weird is actually happening. For 300 megahertz, you can see there are some places with like lower currents in the tracks. And when we go and when we have a look at the frequencies below 400 hertz, if I go like here, then again something weird is happening. Watch, okay, 400 hertz, I go lower, nothing. And that's weird because for a very, very low frequency, I would actually expect this simulation or this result to look close as the DC analysis results. This is the DC analysis and the results, they look like this. So you can see for DC currents, these are flowing with the closest way. But if we go to the AC analysis, then even for very, very low frequencies, these currents, they look actually differently. They are kind of shaped as the tracks. Leave comments. What do you think about these two situations? What do you think why these results for very low frequencies, they are not exactly same as the results for DC analysis? And what do you think why the simulation results about 1 megahertz are actually changing like this? By the way, if you are curious, this is how the PDN graph looks for this board. This can help you maybe to get an idea of what is happening about the 1 megahertz. When we have a look at the DC analysis results of the board with the big cut in the middle, this is how it looks. Okay, so this is the board with the big cut in the ground plane, and there is only this small place where these two planes are basically connected together. So this is how the DC analysis looks. This is something what I would expect. Okay, all the currents, they just flow through this very small piece of connection, and yeah, this is how I would imagine this. But watch what is going to happen when we switch to the AC analysis results. For the small frequencies, very, very, not small, low. For the low frequencies, Again, I would expect the results to look very similar as the DC analysis. They are different. So what do you think? Why they are different? And watch what is going to happen when we will increase the frequency. So I'm going to change it. And you can see here, okay, I'm changing the frequency. I'm increasing the frequency. And this is what is happening. Interesting. So it looks like the currents, they are flowing below the tracks, and then there is this big gap, so they flow around through this small gap which is here. When we go higher than 1 megahertz, again something weird is happening. You can see the currents, they spread a little bit, and it looks like in some parts of the track the currents are missing. I really don't know what this means. I have no clue. If you know, leave comments. And for the highest frequency, 300 megahertz, this is how it looks. I'm going to change this range so we can see this a little bit differently. And I'm going down with the frequencies. Interesting, no? See? Wow. What is this? What is this? And this is something what I would expect, maybe, yeah? So this is okay, but what is about 1 megahertz? I don't know. Okay, and one more time, I'm going to change this to 1000, and now we will go up again. Interesting. I have no idea what this means. Okay, so again, I'm going to show you PDN graph. This is how it looks. And if you have any ideas why it looks like this, I'm curious to know. If anyone would like to know how the first simulation looks for different range, I'm going back to our previous board. This one, and I'm going to change this range to 1000. Let's have a look. Again, something what I would never expect. Why this is happening? All the power supplies, they are exactly the same. And also all the sinks, they are set exactly the same. So why this looks differently? I will change this to 100 and let's go up one more time. Okay. By the way, even these VRMs and these sinks are exactly the same. There is something what is different between these tracks and what can actually influence the results. I'm really curious if you know what it is. And That's everything for today's video. I really hope there will be a lot of comments below this video. And I would like to let you know I did not forget about the decoupling capacitor video. I'm working on part 3. I still need to make a call with Florian. I also need to make a call with Eric. So you will get answers on your questions from your comments. See, the comments are really, really important. But this time, for this video, I would like to know what you think about what was in these simulations. And yeah, if you like this video, don't forget press like button, of course, like button, yeah. If you would like to see more videos, don't forget to subscribe. Again, it's important, it's helping me to see that the content what I create, it makes sense, people like it, and yeah, it motivates me to, it gives me energy to create more and more videos. So thank you very much for watching, thank you very much for liking, subscribing, and see you next time. Bye!